We are back with some OUPL finals, and we got DJ versus Chilled Shadow, and we see Mega Altaria plus a Magneton, which confirms that Altaria won't have a fire move, because the Magneton is pretty much dead to get rid of stuff like Skarmory and Ferrothorn. So I could see the Altaria being like mono attacking, but like Dragon Dance and Refresh or Heal Bell. Okay, let's look at the other team. It's probably Zadwai. Most of the time it's Zadwai when it's paired with T-Terra. But he also has Doggy. Like, so he has some trapping going on there. If it's... I'm not really sure if it's Rockstar or Rocks Doggy. It could also be Rocks Clef, actually, on Chilled Shadow's team. Rocks Clef makes some more sense if he's banned Tar. So, his Zard is probably walled by Heatran when he has a Doggy. It's kind of interesting, these trapper teams. But yeah, let's see what happens in the game, as just goes for Gyarados on the Clefable, doesn't want to play around. I mean, if it's Bolt Clef, it eats it up anyway, but yeah. The Zard comes in, and last time he doubled out the Zard, if I recall correctly. Predicting, maybe he's Zard Y and he gets walled by Altaria. I assume that's the case, that he gets walled by Altaria. Because before Altaria Mega evolves, it has the ability that, like, this is Cloud 9 that weakens, like, weather effects. Data Cloud 9. While this Pokemon is active, the effects of weather conditions are disabled. Okay, yeah, that's what I meant, disability. We do have, this is OEPL Finals, if I didn't mention it. We do have Ricardo vs. Topty Boy going on later. I hope I'm gonna be able to catch that. Might actually upload that before this game. But yeah, this is the Cloud 9 Altaria, probably. Because it eats it up decently well. I think that would have done more if it didn't have Cloud 9. It doesn't. Does it show Cloud 9 if the Mon gets sent out? Maybe it's Natural Q, I'm not sure. If it's a bulky Altaria, it could also not be Cloud 9. He doesn't want a Mega Evolve, which makes me think that he's Cloud 9 because he wants to keep the ability, but I haven't called. Let me actually close some tabs in the background. Okay, so this Clefable can now either go for Rocks if it has that, or he can go for Moonblast. The Magneton can come in, but it's a fire move Clefable that's really risky for the Magneton to come in, so I would probably go into Mew here, depending on the set. Yeah, exactly, I would go into Mew too. He makes that play, and I assume this is gonna be knockoff Mew with Will-O-Wisp, the standard set pretty much in Auras. As the Zardwai gets pretty much a free switch in, but as long as there's no Rocks up, the Altaria can switch in fine into the Zard. If this had HPIs, this would be a different story. But yeah, there's no Zygarde is like pretty common in Sun and Moon, so you see sometimes you see Zard Y with HPIs. I don't really see it in Auras. I assume this. Yeah, not I assume. What I meant to say is it only has 8 Fire Blasts, so like eventually the Altaria will wall out even more, as he goes for Softball there, makes a nice play in case the opponent wants to double, and he could have also lived the Fire Blast and the Sun would have ended, so it would have been fine unless he would have gotten burned. And now he can go for Knock Off. He's just gonna go back to Zard, right? Yeah, at first I wasn't sure if this is for OUPL, but we have it confirmed here because Ricardo's in the chat and his team is in the finals. And I think he's on Chilled Shadow's team because he said go chill. And he's not on Medibrox's team. Medibrox's team is Medibrox and Obi's team is the team that DJ is on. So he's just gonna roost a Fire Blast here and Terry eats it up. But Terry's gonna roost back to full as Zard does the same. I kinda wanna call if that's Cloud 9, but I assume it is, because Zard Y with Fire Blast, it hits so hard in the Sun, like... Yeah, if you guys haven't seen my Smoktris series upload yesterday between Flaming Teen and Solvent, I mentioned in Game 3... Oh, this is probably Fist Death Clef, so it can eat it up. But yeah, Altaria beats this one-on-one. But yeah, what I meant to say is I mentioned that I'm gonna be uploading some World Cup qualifiers between India and... who's India playing? Metro? US Metro, I think. Don't remember 100%. And Latin America is playing Bangladesh, if I recall correctly. I won't record that many games, but I'm trying to catch that game from my man BTB and maybe some others. This might be HPI or Sludge Bomb, okay. Doesn't get the poison, so this Altaria probably just wins. If he doesn't get the poison here... Even if he gets the poison, the Altaria can still roost off, but the poison would be super annoying for Darius. But otherwise, I don't see how he beats this Altaria, like... And there's the poison, okay, so... Now he basically has to... spam roost, and he doesn't really heal anything because of Sludge Bomb damage plus poison. So, never mind, he decides to just pick this off. How many PP did Sludge Bomb have? Because if Sludge Bomb has less PP than Roost, he could have just kept roosting. Well, Sludge Bomb has 16 PP. Yeah, so he probably couldn't have kept roosting because he only had like 12 roosts left, and Sludge Bomb maybe had like 12 or 13 left too. As yeah, the Zard outspeeds the Altaria, which confirms that it's a really bulky set. Like, it was super bulky. Because it still got outspeed at plus 1. Dang, that Altaria could have swept if he didn't get the poison, but it was about to happen, right? What he could have done is, like, go Mew on the Sludge Bomb and, like, try to synchronize, but... I mean, he already had a Dragon Dance up, so I can understand why he just went for game. So if he Scarf Magneton, that's always really tough for DJ. Because the Duck Geo is in the back, so he kind of has to go for Flash Cannon, which means the Zard can just stay in. If Chill Shadow predicts it correct, and get another kill. I don't think he's Edge on Kelly, because Volcarona is not that common in RS slash XY. Also, he does have that Altaria to check Zard Y pretty well, so I don't think he would have Stone Edge on Kelly for Zard Y. So, looking at his team, I don't think he has anything that can all go to Zard unless he's a Scarf, Stone Edge, Landorus. We can calc real quick how much a Magneton does to a Charizard Y. Let's say it's Charizard Scarf. Damn it, mistype. Charizard Y. Oh, you draw a Wallbreaker. T-Bolt does 83 to 98.9, and that's if the Zard doesn't have bulk investment. So let's go Kelio and Hydro Pump does a good chunk, but it doesn't Oko. If he's a bulky Starmie, Chill Shadow can go to Starmie if he wants to keep the Zard healthy, because the Zard puts in a lot of work now. But he can also just go for Solar Beam and get the kill, as long as he avoids a crit here from the Kelio. He cannot get Oko'd. Let's run the calc real quick. Let's say he specs Kelio. Hydro Pump does 79 to 93, so that's a really good chunk. Yeah, I think we Scarf Magneton and like specs Kelio. I guess he could also be Rest Talk Kelio with Splash Blade. That's like something that people use to check Bishop and Weavile in Auras. But yeah, that's... Oh, the sun is up. I was about to say that did nothing. That's not specs, was my first thought, but then I realized the sun is up. So we can calc that real quick, Kelio versus Starmie, just to find out if it's specs. I don't think it is. I think it is, was what I meant to say. Hydro Pump does 58, but let's say the sun is up. Hydro Pump does 29 to 34. Okay, so it did less, but... I was calcing was offensive Starmie, so this is probably like, yeah, probably HP invested Starmie. And maybe it's Cobra Berry, because he doesn't have leftovers. I don't really know what this item would be. He tries to burn the Ferrothorn, doesn't get it, as he's gonna switch into Zard breaking the Power Whip. Maybe this doesn't have power. Oh, we already revealed this entire moveset. Spikes Protect Jabble. See, I wasn't paying that much attention. So he doubles into Tyranitar here. Probably going for Superpower. Oh, Fire Blast? Okay, okay. And he gets the burn, which sucks. Wait. So that confirms that he's pretty much bulky tower if he's fire blast, right? I thought he was bent around, I thought he would go for a different move. Yeah, burn sucks. This is a smart move on Darius' side. Spamming stealth rocks so this time he can never get rid of rocks. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't think about fire blast teeter. I just don't really see defensive Tita that often on teams that don't have Excadrill, so I didn't expect it. He's just gonna spin again, Stealth Rock again here. Because if the Starmie spins, the Landris is gonna die to burn and just rocks again. So he goes for recalibrating them rocks. Oh man! Oh, I was about to say, maybe he can Rapid Spin kill him, but burned us more, burned us 12% in auras, we're not in Sun and Moon. He's gonna flash can here, I assume. Yup. Cause he doesn't never wanna let you never wanna let the doggy come in for free. Now he's gonna go into Charizard, Chill Shadow that is. I mean still can live a hit, but I assume he's gonna actually the rocks are up, the rocks are up. He can go back into Starmie here. Yeah, he can go back into Starmie here. This is a free rapid spin for Chill Shadow. Like Darius can double, but I don't think he can prevent the rapid spin because Starmie outspeeds everything. Yeah, this is a free Starmie here. Cause you wanna get rid of the rocks for the Zard, so yeah. Going hard Zard shouldn't be the play that I said first, that was my bad. But yeah, we do have some Smoktus coming. I'll probably upload the Smoktus before this one. It's gonna be a kick-ass. I wasn't entirely pretty hyped for that, cause I've seen kick-ass play lately. And Circuit was PokeDG Gamer and he's playing so good, like. I love how good he's in Sun and Moon. I don't know about the other tiers. Actually, he's not bad in auras either. He brought some stall last time. Actually, let's focus on the game. So he does decide to get a Brox. I thought he would have doubled into Starmie to get the spin off. But Tita was able to live a flash can anyway, the next flash can, unless there was a mineral, the first one. So he's probably gonna go Kelly and the Fire Blast. I don't know why he went Ferrothorn on this when he showed Fire Blast. Unless he predicted the double switch into Starmie, but then again this doesn't have Power Whip so it can't even touch the Starmie. He's gonna go Kelly on a predicted Fire Blast and dodge it, which is deserved. He already got hexed enough. Aerobomb picks off the teeter and now Starmie gets the rapid spin off. And I think Zardwai should win this game. Zardwai plus Dougie is so annoying for Darius because you can never click T-Ball with the Magneton even if the Zard is in range. I mean he can click it if he gets the play correct, but it's rough. Oh, the Zard is actually in range. I think it's the roll, if I recall correctly. Or maybe I should turn his music down a bit. His music is loud, what the flip. Maybe that's just me. So I got my new earphones and I got that nice sound at the moment. I mean, compared to my last earphones I had, they're like way better. Yeah, I think he might go Magneton on the spin. Or he might just go for damage on the Starmie. Oh, not sure what this other play is. Because if he goes Mew on the rapid spin, the Zard just gets a free switch in. He does go Ferrothorn, wants to give the Starmie some iron barbs. But the thing is, he can't even touch this, so the Starmie can fish for skull burns. Yeah, either he can fish for skull burns or he can go hard into Zardwai. He's either gonna lead seed or. Okay, he doesn't get the burn there. So we're gonna see the Zard switch. Okay, he runs to recover first, that's smart to get health back. Yeah, that's pretty smart. Chill Shadows should win this, but it's not over yet. That burn sucks. Yeah, if Altaria didn't get poisoned, it was over, but then again at 30%, then he spammed Sludge Wave, so it was about to happen. It's funny, he can get rid of Leech Seed with Rapid Spin. I mean, Leech Seed only has so many PP, so he can't keep doing this forever. He only has 10 left. And I'm not sure if this is the first game that's played, because sometimes the score is not really updated in the OUPL thread, and also Most people don't care about EPL anymore because World Cup is around the corner. But there's like some really cool games. There's like Gypsy King vs TDK. I hope that game happens and I hope I can catch it. The deadline is like on Monday at like midnight Eastern time, so when Tuesday starts, if I recall correctly. Like, on Monday it's 23:59 o'clock or however you say that. Like, it's basically 6 a.m. my time on Tuesday when the deadline is, so I'm not gonna be able to record all the games, but I'm gonna do my best to catch some. Because I know some people are gonna play late, like, I don't know how late, but I know that some people probably will play like 1 or 2 a.m. my time. And it's not World Cup, so it's not like, if it was World Cup I would definitely stay up, but if it's for this, I might stay up, I will see, but if I feel like it, I'll still stay up, but it's not like 100% that I want to get these games. But I don't mind, like, it's still finals, even though it's only OUPL, like, cool. Yeah, what's the English word for this? Man, I only know the German word, that sucks. He says you're going Magneton here. So if somebody's Dougie is a Focus Sash. Otherwise he could also go in the Dougie on the Ferrothorn. But he's just basically stalling out the lead seats from the Ferrothorn here. I think Shield Shatter should win this game if he just plays it well. From now, like, he has definitely the tools to win at this point. After Altaria died. Yeah, well, what's dying to the Zard? I mean, even if he goes Keldeo, he's gonna take 5 million from a Fire Blast. I mean, you can go for Protect here, but it doesn't really do anything other than getting rid of one Sun Turn. I guess his play is to dodge a Fire Blast, maybe. Like, that's his hope. I mean, he did get hexed a little bit, but like I said, Slash Bomb 30%, it will poison, like, you can't really expect it to not poison when it's like, when he like spam Slash Bomb. Okay, this seed. I'll pause it real quick. And JMP quoting Ricardo, take the win. It's just a joke, probably. Yeah, PokerDG Gamer is an OU Circuit Finals, by the way. I already mentioned it, I think. And I'll be looking forward to his finals game because he's playing a good friend and hope I can catch that game live. But I don't know, Mantis not coming back. Yeah, this reminds me of yesterday, OU Circuit where Kick-Ass just kept timing out. Yeah, so this boy is still disconnected and they finally started the timer. I think if he started the timer early, he would have timed out now. I don't know if he's going for a timer win here. Whose man is this who called? Padlop? Oh, let me call him again. I pause the recording. Yeah, so Chilled Shadow came back and he's gonna click Fire Blast here, pretty sure Roost. But yeah, this Kelly is gonna get blown away. Oh my, what's 61? Zarma is a beast. I don't know if I can kill from this range, but Stami can switch in, especially in the sun. So he kinda has to make a double here, but even then it's still tough for Darius. Ferrothorn is pretty much useless, besides throwing out some seeds left and right. Magneton always has to predict correctly, it's kinda hard. And yeah, Kick-Ass I wasn't intending should be in 5 minutes. Like, the stun is so obvious here, like, you have to double out, I think. Double into Magneton or double into... Oh, he disconnected again, my lord. I'll try to get someone and call, and while I pause it, my man Padlop, his Discord doesn't work, so we have to call on Skype, which sucks, because not everyone has Skype that I wanted to call with for the next S2 series. Oh, the timer is off. Don't click the timer. Hello? Oh. Kiki, so this guy's back again, and yeah, like this dummy is free here. I mean, Shellshadow can make a really aggressive play and stay in, put it in a double, and Fire Blast again, but he doesn't really have to make that play, I feel. Did he double Fire Blast? Then he just wins. Okay, he didn't. I mean, this dummy was so obvious there, but now it's between Flashkin and Thunderbolt. And he does Flashkin, try to catch the doggy. I feel like this was a fine play for Chilled Shadow, because if he loses his Starmie, then he goes into Dougie afterwards, traps the Magneton, and Zadwai should just win the game from there. Yeah, so I think that was like a non-losing play for Chilled Shadow. Like, this is over, like, we don't have to... Like, I don't see how we can win now. It's just gonna lead C here, and Zard might Roost, predicting the Protect, but I will probably just click Fire Blast. Just click Fire Blast. Yeah, he did just click that, and the Mew gets cooked. Surprised that it even lived that, so it has some Spadef, I assume. At least max HP investment or something like that. Definitely. I mean, he just has to hit another Fire Blast. He can also Kalk if Soul Beam kills. He doesn't want to risk missing. But he just hits, and this Zard is well trained, and Chilled Shadow picks up the win. Like, I'm pretty sure he picks up the win. Because if he goes Magneton, he just goes Starmie again. Actually, never mind, because if he T-Bolts, Darius still has a slight chance of winning, I think. If he T-Bolts, okay, never mind. If he T-Bolts and the Starmie dies, then Kellyo could have won, maybe. Actually, never mind, Dougie outspeeds Kellyo. Yeah, the Kellyo would have to be Scarf, then it could have won after the Starmie died. But I think the Kel's specs... If the Kel was Scarf, it actually could have won after Starmie went down, yeah. I mean, what is he supposed to do here? He can try to burn the Starmie, he can try to double into Magneton, but I don't think it makes a difference, because he could have gone to Magneton in the first place anyway then, if he doubles into Magneton. Yeah, like this. Okay, he gets a crit, so there's the... There's the win condition. Get some revenge hex. Let me see. I don't understand what this item on the Starmie is, though. Bulky without leftovers. I've never really seen that. I expected Koba earlier. He DCs again. Come on, dude. The Astros game is starting every second. Don't do this. Man says, I've had enough. I'm starting the timer. Ricardo is going insane. Well, time to pause my recording again. Okay, Keith, we're back, and he just goes for a safer cover. Stummy outspeeds Kellyo anyway. And. I mean, yeah. Just gonna stall us out of lead seats because he doesn't want to let his Zard get too low. I can see him going Zard now, though. What is this game, Zim or was it DK? I think it's just for fun. Oh, man's bringing the young barrel. Zemmer got a nice star record tall kiss. Probably metronome. Boy said, what's this for anyway? Can I would be like happy if they could finish today before the S2's game. That would be really appreciated, as he's gonna reach seed again, I assume. Or switch out into Scarf Magneton. I mean, let's think this through. If he sacks he has to keep the Zard, I think. Deceive again, come on. So if he, let's just think this through. If he sacks the Starmie to a T-Bolt, Ductrio would revenge this, right? And then, yeah, I think he can just afford to sack the Starmie here. Then Ductrio revenge this, and unless I like completely fucked up with my Kalix and the Kalios Scar for some reason. But I don't think it's Scar from the damage that has been doing. I'm going off a bulky Starmie. If it's offensive Starmie, I was fooled the entire time. It's offensive recovers Starmie. Yes, it could be Scarf Kill, but I don't think it is from the damage it has done. Dude. Like, yeah. I mean, you can still miss Fire Blast, definitely. But Arena Trap is like, oh man, I hate Arena Trap. Stupid ability. He's back. I don't know what is with all these people that have bad internet when they play in tournaments. Like, I mean, I had bad internet for a long time, so you can't really blame them if they don't have access to it, or maybe he's on phone or something, he didn't have another time to play this game. I'm not sure about the background details. Yeah, I don't see why it's taking him so long to click a move though. Like, I don't see what he loses from sacking Starmie. Like, he knows his Starmie spread and he can calc if the Kalio specs. I don't know his Starmie spread. But I assume specs Kalio, and if he can confirm that, then his sacking Starmie and then revenging this with Dagi should win him the game, right? Unless he misses some Fire Blasts. I mean, maybe I'm completely wrong here in the S. Does he have another way of winning? That is even safer. But he has 5 tabs open. 5 smog to his tabs, what the fuck? Yeah, I'll pause it until he makes a move, dude. I'm not trying to like sit here for 5 hours. Okay, so what happened? We did miss some turns. He did switch out, he did sack the Starmie, and Darius makes a Lord play, goes for Volt Switch, so this way he prevents his Magneton from getting trapped. I didn't even think about that. That he can also Volt Switch, not only T-Bolt, cause so that. Yeah, you guys can definitely see, I didn't think about all the opportunities there. Feels bad. But he did get that play correct, he did get rid of the Starmie. Now the Zard comes back in, basically. Because he doesn't want to lose the Sash on his Ductrio, because Scarf, Magneton should outspeed Dougie, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I mean, that was a gold play. Like, I think Zard is his only play. I don't know why he's taking so long. Like, and there he's Windus now. He can potentially win this, but it's hard still. He's playing like gold, holy flip. I mean, I'm definitely, I definitely messed up a bit with this narration. Okay, he sends out a Zard, and I mean, he can roost here, but if he goes like hard Magneton and roost, I mean, it would be another 50-50 kind of, but Because a Magneton Roost, I think that would be bad for... It would be bad for Chill Shadow. Potentially, if Darius can predict correct. So all this Ferrothorn is doing is... potentially breaking the sash from the Dougie and annoying the Tsar with a Leech Seed. So what is the play here for Darius? I'm not really sure if he wants to, if he should sack this. I think he has to sack the Ferrothorn. Yeah, what am I saying? He sacks the Ferrothorn and Kelly gets a kill. Yeah. Unless he goes hard Dougie and avoids the burn, but... yeah, he can win now if he sacks Ferrothorn. He can, like, if he sacks Ferrothorn, he can either go Magneton and try to win a 50-50, or he can go Kelio and get a kill, basically. But if he goes Kelio... Chill Shadow can go hard Dougie, and if he avoids the Sculpin, he can revenge the killed. And then the Magneton can't kill the Zard, because it has to lock itself into Flashcan to kill the Dark Trio, and Flashcan definitely wouldn't kill the Zard from 38. Kick-Ezra's online, he's asking for Nintendo. Please wait a bit, my dude. I don't want to miss the start. Just go kill, and he's gonna click. Scald should kill from this range. I don't see a reason to click anything other than Scald. Yup. Dougie's gonna pick this off, and if it's Sash Dougie, yeah, Chill Shadow still wins. That's what I'm saying. I think maybe he had to win a 50-50. He still played this well, though. It's, doesn't even bring it down to the potential Sash. Wow, I thought it would for sure. What? So Chill Shadow picks up the win for... I think the Kavai Kratos Menas. Let me pause real quick and show you guys the thread. Yeah, we are here, OEPL Finals, BBC Kings vs. Kavai Kratos Menas, and we see... Score was 1-1 before this. Oh yeah, I forgot about these old gens. DPP and ADV was already played. So the score is 2-1 now. Chill Shadow wins with DJ, and not sure if any of these other games have happened yet. I know the Ricardo game should be in like 4 hours from now, 3 hours and 50 minutes, something like that. I'll try to catch that. What else? That's basically it. I'm trying to catch the Smogtooth series now for you guys, so thank you for watching. This will probably go up after the Smogtooth anyway. And Dogwitch signing out. Yeah. Kinda messed up the narration, I feel bad. Peace out, friends.